Since CAT is done, I wanted to make a video on how to prepare for interviews. So the first component of any interview is current affairs and GK. Now I'm not going to say ki wo Manorama khareedo, Manorama padho, because it's humanly impossible. That book is so fat, there is no way we can finish the whole book and remember all of the things, right? Instead, what I would say is to remember stuff about where you're from. Suppose you're from Mumbai, you remember who the power holders are, who's the governor, who's the chief minister, which party is ruling. Remember stuff about the history, what are the important monuments, why were they built, what is your favorite part in the city, what is the history of that place. So try to remember geographical information about where you're from, okay? Second is to remember political issues that are going out right now and your stance on it. So for the stance, I would say try to read more of editorial pieces or, you know, op-ed pieces, because usme you will get a perspective. And it's not just important to know what's happening, they are also looking at what your perspective is. And there is no right perspective, wrong perspective. You know, nobody is going to judge you for supporting a particular side. What matters more is the fact that you have an opinion, which shows that you are well read. So focus mein sirf sab rat ke koi fayda nahi hai, have a perspective on it. Then the third part of current affairs in GK would be to know about your favorite hobbies, right? So suppose you're saying you like singing. What do you like about singing? Do you know the basics of Western classical? Do you know the basics of Indian classical? Theek hai, if you've not been formally trained in music, that's also fine. Know about your favorite artist. Now it could be anybody. For me, it's Taylor Swift. Know about Taylor Swift. Where she was born? Where was she born? You know, what is her style of music? What is her vocal range? What are some of her achievements? So try to remember stuff like that. Don't just say ki I like singing. You can talk about Muhammad Rafi. Know about his biography. Know about his, you know, most popular songs, the awards he's won, etc. So whatever may be your interest, it could be sports, it could be, you know, music, art, know the stalwarts of that industry, know about the stalwarts, and also try to understand the various intricacies of that. Suppose you like cricket, know the rules of the game, know what are some of the biggest achievements made in the game, what is the difference between each cricketing style. So these are some important points to remember. Okay, so that is with the GK current affairs part. Second are your HRQs, questions about yourself. Now this is the easiest part because you know yourself the best, right? Obviously the person sitting in front of you doesn't know you as well as you do. So aap apne bare mein expert ho, right? And with that in mind, try to remember, try to make a note of, you know, where you were. So have an introduction paragraph ready. Try to memorize it, but don't make it seem ki tum rat ke aaye ho. So make it seem a little more organic. Like right now when I'm speaking, I'm taking these pauses, I'm thinking, I'm saying so those little pauses also make it very organic. So instead of just being blah 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 blah, try to remember and make it seem a little more authentic. Okay, so in your introduction, try to talk about where you were born, your work ex, your interests, your internships, social causes you like, and why you want to do this MBA. Now, why an MBA is a very standard question, which a lot of us will get asked, right? Usme the idea is to show how this degree is going to aid you in your future goal. And your future goal could be anything. You know, you can literally say something like, I want to be a filmmaker, and this MBA is really going to teach me how to work in teams, how to manage people. You can basically create a narrative around it. Right, so that is completely dependent on you. But if you want to play it safe, you can obviously say something like, I want to do marketing, I want to do consulting, and this degree will really help me. And the most important thing to remember is, what are you bringing to the table? Because every IIM, XLRI, all of these top institutes are looking for people who will add value to the classroom. They are hand-picking, cherry-picking each one of you. So if they don't see something unique about you, your chances of getting selected are, they dwindle. So try to highlight what is unique about you. Don't fake it. It could be anything. You can draw from your own life experiences. You might have had one particular life experience that has really changed you as a person. Talk about it as if you can, if you want to. It will really add to the credibility of what you're saying. And last thing about whether you need coaching for interviews, I took coaching in my last attempt of the CAT. I went to Career Launcher. Zyada fayda to nahi hua, very honestly. But it helped me gain confidence because you know, I felt ki acha theek hai, maine iske liye bhi preparation kiya hai. I did some mock interviews. Even though the mock interviews weren't of much difference, it was nice to build confidence because I was talking to people who had a lot of experience in this domain, and unse jab validation milta hai, andar ka confidence kafi boost hota hai. And I had a lovely mentor who really really helped me, one of the teachers. But it was overpriced. It was way too overpriced. So that's the truth. This is not to turn this channel into a promotional channel, but I'm also offering some mock interviews and just general insight prep. If you're interested, just drop me a mail and we can see how to take it from there. Best of luck. I hope this helps. I will drop my email ID niche, so if you want to try and come for the mock interviews or, you know, general prep. I'm not even gonna call it mock interviews, I think I'll just call it guidance for interview prep. If you are interested, drop me a mail. And yeah, see you another day, another video.